A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 2nd May, on the front page you have UN Security Council designates Masood Azhar as global terrorist. So what we discussed on front page news yesterday, that China has now said that progress has been made in designating him as a global terrorist and China removing its technical hold. So now that's what has happened. He has been designated as a global terrorist on the 1267 Sanctions Committee of United Nations. So, but then the reason for the decision does not mention the Pulwama attack as such. Then this is 15 Jawans killed as Maoist trigger IED in Gadchiroli. So this is in Gadchiroli in Maharashtra, where Maoist stronghold prevails. So the Jawans as such, they were on their way to provide security at a police station and an IED, that is improvised explosive device, blew up and 15 Jawans and a civilian were killed. Then below you have record GST revenue collection in April. So GST revenue collection has been 1.13 lakh crore in April 2019, which is the highest collected so far. And below you have clean chit to Modi on Latur speech too. So Election Commission has given a clean chit to Prime Minister Narendra Modi on his speech in Latur in Maharashtra on April 9. So this was where he had appealed to first time electors to dedicate their vote to Pulwama martyrs and to the soldiers who carried out Balakot airstrike. So the Election Commission said that this does not violate Model Code of Conduct. Later we have seen how the Election Commission has stated that the military cannot be used for political purposes, it should not be politicized, but here it has given it a clean chit. And above you also have another news, Chief Justice appears before Bobde panel. So this is the in-house inquiry committee on sexual harassment charges, in which the CJI also appeared before it. Yesterday we saw how the lady appeared before the panel, now it's the CJI. On page 5 you have fishermen warned of high waves as Fani nears coast. So, Odisha has directed administration to ensure 100% evacuation in vulnerable areas too. And this is Chandrayaan 2 gets new launch window in July. So, India's second moon mission, which will have a lander and a rover too, which has been put off many times, now is proposed to be launched in July 2019. On page 6 you have curbs on civilian traffic between Srinagar and Baramulla lift. This is restrictions which were imposed after the Pulwama terror attack, that twice a week the national highway NH44 was closed. So this has now been lifted. On page 7 there is this continuation of the front page news regarding CJI appearing before the Bobde panel, and below you have regarding the Maoist attack in Gadchiroli. It is said the ambushed Jawans ignored protocol. The road recce was not done, nor did they wait for the arrival of anti-landmine vehicle. So that would have prevented the killing. So they were travelling in a mini truck and were ambushed and killed in an IED blast. Then on the editorial page, the first editorial is power shift. So this is regarding the ruling on Puducherry. The Madras High Court, we saw in yesterday's newspaper, has ruled in favor of the elected government in Puducherry and has reprimanded the lieutenant governor of Puducherry. So this, it says, is inspired by the ruling of on Delhi also. So this is discussed here. And because both are union territories, so Delhi is also a national capital territory, but they have elected government of their own as well. So these are the only two out of the 7 union territories, Delhi and Puducherry, which have elected governments. Then below you have the cost of resistance. So this is regarding antimicrobial resistance, how it is spreading uncontrolled. So it says India must brace for the economic shocks from uncontrolled antimicrobial resistance, because it will come at a huge cost, because medicines, known medicines, would not work and would result to deteriorate the health. It would affect the health of the population, which of course has economic consequences too. Spending on medication plus also not being able to earn. Then the lead article, The Savior's Burden. So this is regarding SPA-BSP Alliance. You can skip it, it's political. And this is regarding Julian Assange too. So standing up for Julian Assange. It says ensuring his freedom is essential to uphold free speech and media freedom on a global scale. So he brought out details regarding, you know, corrupt practices in USA, and is he founded Wikileaks. So that has not been to the liking of US. It found out about its Afghan role as such, to role in Afghanistan in the war. It's not just US, you can see there have been other details also which his organization Wikileaks has published, like on the Turkish President Recep Tayyip Erdogan also. So that is there. So this is how the people have right to information, right to know what's going on, and these confidential, so-called confidential records may not always be containing confidential data, but something which the government wants to hide. So that has been brought out in the open by him. On UPED page, you have this coverage on the Citizenship Amendment Bill. It says the real aim is not to segregate non-citizens on the basis of religion. So this is regarding that, how it speaks on religious lines. Religious minorities from Muslim majority countries are facilitated in citizenship. And this is fighting polio in Pakistan. So this is regarding the polio inactivated polio vaccine which was administered in the polio vaccination program in Pakistan recently, which resulted in some children admitted to hospitals as such too, and which resulted in attacks on polio health workers, and the polio program was then halted. So it says instead of insisting on the oral polio vaccine, using the inactivated polio vaccine along with other vaccines will help. So when oral polio vaccines are concerned there, other polio vaccines can also be considered. That's what this article says. And this is beyond Khalistan. So this talks of how India risks alienating Sikh diaspora if it focuses on only this one issue of Khalistan. And this is also important in India-Canada relations. So Khalistan was the demand of Sikhs for a separate nation for themselves. So some Khalistan activists are said to be still active in and supporting the cause abroad, especially from Canada. Then on page 10 below, you have clean chit on Latur speech 2, the continuation from the front page. And this is Rahul gets election commission notice for speech in MP. So in Madhya Pradesh, Rahul Gandhi gave a speech in which he said that Prime Minister Narendra Modi has brought a new law for tribal communities, which had a line providing that tribal people could be shot at. So on this, the election commission has sought a report from MP chief electoral officer about the speech and the comments, and the commission has issued a notice to Rahul Gandhi on this. But then we have discussed about such a law for forests. So this is the coverage on the new law, a fact check given by Times of India. We have discussed this actually in news as well, you should recollect. It is the Indian Forest Act 2019, the Amendment Act, to amend the obsolete Indian Forest Act 1927, which is a colonial era act. So it was highly criticized too. This is presently just a draft, it has not yet been made into a law, but it says that forest officials have a right to have the power to prevent commission of an offense to the extent that they can use firearms too. Means they can shoot as such too. Do as little injury to person and property, but then they have this been given this power to shoot, to apprehend any person engaged in commission of an offence in that. So of course near the forest there would be tribals, and this is the power which has been given to forest officials. So this has been referred to by Rahul Gandhi. Then on international page, you have this coverage regarding Assange. He is sentenced to 50 weeks in jail by a British court, so for breach of bail conditions. And this is rioting breaks out after Guaido's call for Venezuela military to rise. So this is unrest in Venezuela. The Venezuelan opposition leader, which is supported by the Western nations, so he has called for the military to rise, and this has resulted in rioting in the country. US has prepared for military action to stem the crisis too. That's what Mike Pompeo has stated. who is US Secretary of State. And you should know that the government in Venezuela is of President Nicolas Maduro. So he is the socialist government here, which is opposed by the Western nations. Then on business page you have, Iraq remains top oil supplier to India. It contributes a fifth of India's needs. Even imports from US have increased fourfold from 2017-18. Then there's no news on the last page and no further important news. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website asha.com. Thank you.